guys, it's Rick and Elijah Tooling. Today we're going to go through the steps required to make the holes so that we can install these two common products that are used in our fixtures. So I've got a fixture that's in work right now. So you can see that this fixture has the hole for the invert-a-bolt fastener and the hole for the zip bushing. And that is the most common type of hole that goes into our fixture. We're going to show you the steps. We're going to use acrylic so that we can keep the doors open and run it sequentially. So join me in just a second. We'll get it going. So we've got it set up. These are the EZE Vise Ultimates, nice piece of acrylic. We're going to go through the process tool by tool to make the zip bushing first, and then we'll have a little break, and then we're going to do the fastener, and then I'll install them and I'll show you how we do all that. First tool, we're going to be roughing the hole for the zip bushing. You can see it's jack drilling. You guys are familiar with this. I'm not telling you anything you don't know. All right, next tool coming up. Bigger. This is 5/8. Finishing the bore. It's not being bored, we're circular interpolating it. We can hold that very closely, by the way. This is where you get your tight tolerance with the use of the zip bushing. But we gotta do this properly. We can hold plus or minus a couple tenths all day long, and then positionally as well. This is a threader. We're going to thread mill for the outside threads of the zip bushing. And that completes our hole. All right. So, we've got instruction sheets. I'll put this in front of the camera. These come with all of our product, or many of our products. So it goes through the process of how we do this. These come shipped with your product. But we're going to use the Pro One, which is called out on our instruction sheet. And it tells us to use a setting of 4. So, can we see this?
Yeah, you can see it.
I am not going to use 4 for acrylic because I don't want to crack the block, and I may end up cracking the block anyway, but we'll try it. But anyway, here's your driver. I'm going to take the zip bushing and we are going to screw it in. Thank you. Whoops. There you go. Beautiful. Now we're going to go on to the invert-a-bolt fastener. All right, this is the 3/4 through hole. Now it doesn't go through this block, but this is the size that we call out for through hole. Now we've got this is going to do the ID of the thread. Once again, we're just drilling straight. Now we're going to be doing the chamfer on top. And last but not least, we're gonna thread mill the 12 pitch for the outside thread. There you go. It's as easy as that. Let me, once again, we've got a, here's our sheet that we use to install the fastener. It goes through all the processes for you, so you won't have any difficulty in doing this. I'm gonna go ahead and install a fastener in the hole. So on this particular setting, we tell you to use the setting of 1 on our Pro 1. Remember that this is a left-hand threaded product, and we typically will screw the fastener down almost to the bottom before we start torquing it. So, let's do this. There we go. The point of what I'm doing here is to show you that it's very simple to install these products. You can make your own modular fixture plate. So, great to spend time with you, and we'll see you next time.